Good evening. Okay, thank you. Okay, right. Thanks, Prem, and thanks, Smart CEO, for the opportunity. It was really a privilege to go through so many applications, so much of enthusiasm and startup, and being an entrepreneur, it is really enjoyed sifting through so many ideas and so varied opportunities. It's just that I wish I had more years, more enthusiasm, and more life to be able to pursue all the opportunities that I saw. It's great to be here. Okay, right. So I'll start with some standard caveats. Okay, right. And Mohan is here. He's a finance wizard. He knows past performance is not indicative of future returns, like they say in mutual fund and stocks. So some of my sharings and all the stuff is really based on the past. But we are out there, we are building companies, and every new company, as all of you entrepreneurs know, is a complete and full challenge on its own and has to be built from scratch, okay, right? And while doing this, the other caveat is we have made a lot of stupid mistakes, and again, Mohan Das Pai knows some of the stupid mistakes that we know. He has been a philosopher and advisor and a friend in our journeys. And normally we don't like to talk about our stupid mistakes, because I'm an MBA, I'm from IIM Calcutta. Like typical MBAs, what we do is we construct financial models, we do excellent spreadsheets, Excel spreadsheets and all that stuff before we go in. And if the venture turns out to be successful and something works, we take full credit for it. We say we were so foresightful. And if a venture doesn't take off, or problems happen or mistakes happen, then we blame the environment, we blame the competition, we blame the market, we blame the investors. Sometimes we blame the political parties, Aam Aadmi Party. Whatever we can blame, we start blaming them. So if you find that some of the things that I say is to be too good to be true, okay, right? Believe me, it is actually too good to be true. I'm embellishing them. I'm talking a lot about it. Take it with a pinch of salt, or take it with a bucket of salt. And if you want to know where to buy the bucket of salt, I'm sure you know bigbasket.com. Okay, right? And if you put Smart CEO as the code, you'll also get a 10% discount. Okay, right? Yeah, because that's the flavor of the day. Okay, right? You get discounts to use the thing. Okay, right? And this is also just one man's views. This is not necessarily the only one, or not the right one, or not the last word on it. Because the jury is out, like you all know. And real credit for all of this, okay, right, should go to the actual people in trenches. In Tuta Vista, we had 3,000 teachers working from home across 123 cities in India, who got up in the morning at 2 a.m. and 3 a.m. to teach kids in the U.S. I mean, that is phenomenal work. Not coming and speaking at the events like this, which is very nice, of course. Same thing in Portia Medical. We have 3,000 employees, okay, across 24 cities. Physiotherapists, doctors, nurses, nursing attendants, who work every day, okay, right? So that I get an opportunity to come and speak to you, okay, right? With all those caveats, okay, right? It's really the first and foremost to scaling and growth is, what are you trying to do, okay, right? And this, I think, is the biggest lesson that I have learned, and I'm sure all of you, most of you also share this. You need to choose what game you're going to play. What is going to be the playing field, and do you have the skills to do it in a playing field? I can't run a marathon. I can't run a sprint, okay, right? Can I play baseball, or I have to play cricket? Hockey is different. So one of the things about scaling is not what you do, it's also what you choose to play the thing in. What to scale is important, okay, right? Again, question obviously, when to scale? Do you scale too early, too late? Should you scale first? And what to scale, okay, right? Are you going for after revenue, profitability? All of revenue, profitability, market share, growth rate, gross margin, which one do you want to scale, okay, right? That the problem really with smart people is we are too smart, okay, right? We have too many ideas, okay, right? And we go all over the place. We think we can conquer the world, and that spirit is important. I'm not pulling that down, but it's really, decisions are really every day about what you want to scale, okay, right? And that will determine how far do you go. We are extremely bullish, okay, right, about opportunities in India, okay, right? Whether it is Portia Medical, whether it is Big Basket, Bluestone, Homelane, Housejoy, Fresh Menu, each one of these companies are addressing basic core needs in India. And all of them have started less than 2 years. Portia Medical is less than 2 years old. Homeland House Joy Fresh Menu is less than a year old, okay, right? And we are scaling them. So I think the opportunity for all of us, and that's why all of you are here, some of you are very established companies and grown companies, some of them are in startup. The opportunity in India to be able to build businesses is phenomenal, okay, right? And the way we look at it, for scaling, you don't have to look outside India. India has got such a large market. Pick a big sector, okay, right? Roti, kapda, makan, healthcare, education, entertainment. Each one of those sectors are huge sectors, gives you an opportunity to scale, okay, right? And there, if you go and get rid of pain points, you can build a large scalable business, which gives you a playground to play in. Remember, we are very particular about ensuring that we get to play in a field which is large. Let me just take a moment to explain what I mean. If we were having this conference in Silicon Valley or in US, if people were talking about scaling up, if people were talking about starting business, startup, it's extremely tough for us to do. In US, it's an evolved economy. You have to be really super smart and a genius to start a business. I really mean it. I'm not trying to put down India, okay, but I'm just saying there, so many problems have been solved. You have to be really smart. Have all of you heard of Snapchat? How many of you, raise your hand, have heard of Snapchat? Okay, right? Now, Snapchat, I for the life of me can't understand how Snapchat model works. Okay, right? You take a selfie, okay, right? You take a selfie and you then send the selfie out and 17 seconds or whatever, it will disintegrate. Okay, right? There is no revenue model. Okay, right? There's no revenue model, nothing you just have. Okay, when I tell that to my daughter, who is 23, she says, Dad, you're too old. This is not for you. This is Snapchat is that. And Snapchat was valued at $3 billion, but they said, no, we don't want $3 billion. We want to build a business. It's not worth $3 billion. Now, I just can't get to understand that, okay, right? First of all, if you look like me, why would you like to take a selfie, okay, right? Would you like to take a selfie at all? No, the answer is no, okay, right? Yeah, so next part I understand. If you look like me and the selfie is there, I definitely want it to disappear, okay, right? Okay, right? That is fine, okay, right? So, I mean, how? So you really have to be a genius. Facebook, WhatsApp, Twitter, something like that. In India, I don't need to rack my brain so much. Take grocery, deliver bread, deliver milk, you get big basket. We started 3.5 years back. It's valued currently at $400 million. Okay, see the simplicity of it. Take Portia Medical. No, nothing sexy, nothing glamorous, nothing path-breaking. We will send a doctor, nurse, nursing attendant home, diagnostics and medicines home. Something that has been done, instead of there, we are taking it there. Same like Big Basket, okay, right? But we can create a business, okay, right? In 2 years in Portia Medical, we have 3,000 employees, 24 cities across India, 2 cities in Malaysia, and we are just in the process of closing our Series B round. So that is really the opportunity to scale comes because you get to play in that particular thing, okay, right? Indians are hungry for brands, okay, right? They are aspirational. Tier 2, tier 3 cities everywhere, they see the same video, they see the same channels, they see the same television. The aspiration to own that brand is there, but the reach is not there because all the big chains want to be in major metros and major cities. They have more money to spend. They have a lot more time to spend because they don't have distraction. They don't have Bangalore traffic. Okay, right? Okay, right? So they have lots of time. Okay, right? They have time. They have money to spend. They see their aspiration levels are same or not higher. They are willing to pay for quality and trust more so than us in the metros because they feel they are missing something by being in tier 2, tier 3 towns they are doing. We have seen this in education. Some of the biggest hunger for education for Tuta Vista in India, and we were doing it under along with Manipal and the Manipal K-12 education, Manipal schools. The biggest hunger was tier 2, tier 3 towns. The students will use arm and a leg. In metro, we used to say that the students are pampered. My children are pampered. But there, the hunger is there. So that, you can do that. So you can build a brand to address that. And the cost of building a brand today is a fraction because of digital, online, smartphone, and all of that stuff. That is, again, a great opportunity for us to build. The new technologies, smartphone, GPS location, video, hopefully 4G rollout, all of that gives us ability to be able to use social media, virality, engagement to reach people. Portia Medical, almost, other than some brand building which we have started now, first entire 1 year, the entire budget, we spent 10 crores. was on social media. That's a great opportunity, because the smartphone, if you see, gives you interactivity and direct access to the consumer. It does three things which is never possible before the smartphones came. One, it is always on. Okay, right? Always on. Two, the frequency of usage is very high. All of us are checking smartphone. Even the moment you have a minute, you will check the smartphone. That was not the case before the smartphone. You never used to open your computer and connect a data card and check the internet. That didn't happen. But now the frequency is on. Third, it is GPS enabled. So whether it's Uber or Ola, which uses the GPS location, or even Portia Medical, we use GPS location. Freshmeno uses. So all of it uses that. So the opportunity to be able to build businesses because of the smartphone is phenomenal. And the time to create a brand is very limited. Big Basket, as I said, is a 4-year brand. I'm sure all of you would have heard of Big Basket. Before this revolution came, 10 years back, a brand would have got created in decades. Okay, right? That's an opportunity. And today's consumer has very short time span, very short attention span. Okay, right? They're very distracted. They want to be continuously engaged. They are always on the smartphone. So all of us gives us the ability to be able to build brands. Like we built Bluestone, for example, an online fine jewelry brand. The whole idea behind it was that in India, as a percentage of the retail market, jewelry is 10% of the retail market in India. All of us know our love for jewelry or gold. Now that's a huge scalable opportunity. Plus, you can't see the numbers here, it's not coming out clearly. What it really talks about is that it is 10% of the market, retail market it's 10% of the overall market, but the online penetration in that jewelry market is less than 0.1%. So you see, compared to US, where it's only jewelry is 1% of the overall retail market, in India it's 10%. In US, the penetration is 8%, whereas it's only 0.1%. So that gives a huge opportunity. Similarly, take elder care. We have 144 million Indians over 60 years. That's almost half the population of US. So that kind of opportunity is huge. I'm going to tell you a slightly different, talk about a different scale, okay, right? This is not a growth story company. I'm a small angel investor, okay, right? But it's a nice thing. This photo is of Karni Mata temple in Rajasthan, okay, right? It's one of the most popular temple, but access is difficult. It's known for rats. There is huge amount of rats. The queues are bad, and people go there with a lot of difficulty. Elderly people with disabilities go there, okay, right? And that was seen by one of the entrepreneurs like you as a major opportunity, okay, right? He said, if visiting a temple is so difficult, what is the next best thing to visiting a temple? Okay, right? He came up with this company called Online Prasad. This is a BITS Pilani graduate who used to work Bain & Company. He took his elderly parents to the temple and that had the aha moment, okay, right? Can I bring the temple home and blessings? It's called Online Prasad. Early stage startup. We don't know what's the future for it completely, but look at the opportunity to be able to scale. Religion as a market in India, it's a huge market, okay, right? It's a 40 million, and great for startup. Why is that? There are no returns, okay, right? When the prasad comes home, you don't ask them to take it back like you do with Myntra or Flipkart. Correct? Okay, right? No, sir. You don't do it, okay, right? Two, you don't ask for a discount. How many times have you asked for a discount in a temple? Okay, right? You never ask for a discount. You don't go and say that I want 10% off, 20% off. Okay, right? Recession proof. People are happy. You won an award. You want blessings. You didn't win. In trouble, you want blessings. Okay, right? You are happy. You want blessings. Thank you. It's a great, great potential. So that really is an outlet. Big Basket, all of us know. Okay, right? We have seen it. You need grocery every day. We stock 14,000 items. You do it. So the opportunity is huge. So the fundamental question that comes is, that if you choose a place like that, what all do you scale? Revenue, market share, profit, profitability, number of customers, what is it that you want to scale? That obviously, that and the focus would depend a lot upon what is your objective is, what are you trying to achieve? It will vary with the stage of the company. What are you gunning for? What is your next milestone? If your next milestone is funding, then you have to play the game differently. Okay, right? If the next milestone is reaching break-even, you need to play the game differently, okay, right? And so it depends on the stage of the company and what your model is, okay, right? So that really thing. And after you have narrowed your, decided is your focus going to be narrow, it's going to be broad, based on your vision. Next issue is cash. For all of us, the single biggest issue after that is cash. Because when the cash runs out, the game is over, okay, right? People have never shut down because the valuation was low or the promoters diluted too much, the entrepreneurs diluted too much, never ever. Companies shut down because the last dollar of cash is not there. So never run out of cash when you're scaling, okay, right? There are different kinds of mistakes people do, okay, right? You heard of type A and type B error, okay, right? Scaling too fast or scaling too slow. If it scales too low, somebody else will come and occupy in a winner-take-all market. It's very difficult to compete. I mean, taxi, Uber, Ola is a great example, okay, right? If you scale too fast, you'll slash and burn, you'll run out of cash. And one of the important things in all of us entrepreneurs, I'm sure you all know about it and we all know, is how do you catch the wave, okay, right? Whereas today you see a lot of hype, lot of foreign money coming in, hedge funds money coming in, hot money coming in, and people start scaling too fast without getting the basic metrics right. As a consumer, I'm appalled. Most of the consumer services that I use is appalling. It's pathetic. Why and they are giving discounts so that I use it. Okay, right? They are using investor money to burn it without fixing it. So it's extremely important to fix the basics before you start at scaling. And the typical scalable models where you get, where your gross margin, as you scale, okay, right? Does the operating expenses scale proportionately or they scale at a lower proportion so that your gross margin increases? And Google P&L is a great example. It's an old slide in terms of number, but shows how as the revenue goes, the operating margin keeps going. I'm not saying it's possible in all models, this kind of divergence, but ultimately there has got to be a method to the madness why you are scaling and you need to answer. And in order to do that, you need to scale multiple things, not just users, revenue, technology, hiring people, the processes, the product, all of them has to match and scale, okay, right? Which is possible if you identify what are the friction items in your business model stopping the scale, okay, right? And what do I remove the friction item? It will vary between one to the other, to the other, to the other, okay, right? In Tuta Vista, for example, hiring teachers was a major issue. Okay, right? So we had to solve that. It was not a demand side problem, it was a supply side problem. Supply side problem also, how do you train a 50, 55 year old, 60 year old Indian teacher who doesn't even have a passport to train US American students, that too online, on the internet at 2 a.m., 3 a.m. in the morning? That was a singular problem. And when we cracked it, we were able to scale. So most of the businesses, depending on the business model, will have singular thing. HomeLane is a great example. HomeLane does home setup, fixed furniture for new apartment. When you take over a new apartment from a builder, it does the kitchen, cabinets, and cupboards. Okay, right? When we started, it's a great idea. But the founding team, and they are here, Shrikant, Iyer, Rama, Harinath, and team, they realized that designers is a major choke. Okay, right? And how do you get designers? How do you onboard designers? How do you train designers? How do you give them a technology platform to be able to use that? They did that, and within 3 months, they hit $1 million, 6 crore run rate, once they removed that friction. So it's all about scaling, it's all about identifying the friction point in your business model and removing it. That for scaling, you need to dream big, okay, right? The ambition should be to build a category leader and do whatever it takes, okay, right? Building a brand, scaling it is a tough and a long journey. It doesn't matter whether it's a small brand or a big brand, it takes a hell of a lot of time, okay, right? As an entrepreneur, I'm sure many of you share who have been in the entrepreneurial journey for a long time, some of you are a very young startup, scaling, the ability to pivot, removing the friction and doing that, they are intrinsic ability. Expect it to be hard. We call it the rule of three. Whatever entrepreneurs plan, it takes three times the capital, it takes three times the effort, it takes three times the time to reach the business plan. I have never seen in any of the business plan that we gave to investor at Series A ever turned out to be true. Okay, it just does not happen. So a rule of 3x means it'll take, and expect it to be hard, okay, right? And many a times, startups don't have an ecosystem. You have to create an ecosystem. I gave a HomeLane example, where designer onboarding, like designer marketplace, getting designer on is not there. Similarly, the whole process of doing kitchens, cabinet, wardrobes, entertainment unit was completely broken. There is no organized player. They had to organize it. They had to build virtual reality software so that people can experience it. So you have to virtually create stuff which does not exist. That's important to scale. Otherwise, you will not be able to scale, okay, right? And which means getting into stuff that we have never done before. I mean, like in customer asset, first source, one of the first call centers in India, we became quickly the largest caterer, largest transport company in Bangalore, transporting people at night. And I remember when I met Mohandas Pai in Infosys, he took and showed me around how right from hospitality, number of rooms in their Mysore campus to number of actual clothes, laundry in the Mysore campus, it was on the largest facility in the country. They were not a laundromat, but just sheer by size and scale. And you had to do all of that stuff. There is no better person than Mohan to talk about scaling, because you've seen Infosys, your Infosys scale. So that really is the core I wanted to share. Okay, thank you very much. Okay, right, and all the best to all the award winners and people who competed and contested. It has been a great privilege for me to be part of the jury panel to be able to look through that. Thank you very much.